Hi, I'm Dr. Frederick Burley, President and CEO of COSI, and the host of QED with Dr. B. Now join the animated me for Dr. B in three. Okay. Let's talk about that super exciting S topic. That's right, science. And more specifically, science literacy. So what is science? What does it mean to be science literate? And why should you care? Simply put, science is the process or way of knowing. You wonder why or how, and you try to find out. When scientists observe or experiment, they're trying to understand why something is happening or how does something work. And through this process of asking questions and researching and experimenting, answers emerge. Scientists don't get to decide the truth, they just work really hard to reveal it. And that's pretty awesome. You might be saying, well, science just isn't my thing. Really? Your daily life depends on it. But that's for another session. Think about this. We call the ability to understand and appreciate words and letters literacy. So we call the ability to understand and appreciate science, science literacy. Reading and writing allows you to understand and process information. Science literacy allows you to understand and process the world around you based on objective facts, research, and knowledge. If you can't read or write, that is, if you're illiterate, society agrees that this is not great. From job postings to street signs, words and language surround us every day. Now, you're not expected to read every book in the modern Library of Alexandria or pen beautiful prose like Maya Angelou. But we can all agree that having a basic capacity to read and write are essential to navigating our everyday lives. The same thing goes with science. From depending on the technology in your pocket, to deciding what to put in your body, to the medicines that help heal us, we make decisions influenced by science all day, every day. And you certainly don't need to be a research scientist to make these decisions, but having a basic understanding of how things work will allow you to make better choices and to make them more easily. So, why doesn't society place the same emphasis on science literacy that we do on reading and writing? To tell you the truth, I just don't know. After all, science is totally cool with disagreement. For example, if you think the world is flat, and it's not, by the way, that's Kansas, you're welcome to observe and experiment, gather some data, and share the conclusions you find. Challenges, debates, and new data actually don't hinder, but instead improve our understanding of the universe. Like I said, scientists don't decide the truth. The research, data, and analysis do. But here's the thing. You don't need to have a college degree in science or work in a scientific field to be science literate. Anyone can understand and appreciate how the world works through the lens of science. A person who is science literate knows how to look at data and process it before jumping to conclusions. And that makes them feel more comfortable and confident in the decisions they make. Now, sadly, there are people who wear their science illiteracy like a badge of honor. Some even use it to push agendas that aren't grounded in truth or reality. And with the proliferation of unchecked idea factories like social media and the internet, where everybody has a platform, a voice, and a megaphone, basic science literacy is the key to finding a way through the noise. In fact, it may be your only way to differentiate fact from opinion. Listen, opinions are great, and everybody's got them. But you wouldn't get on an airplane flown by some dude who only has an opinion about how to fly planes. I know I wouldn't. Bottom line, be inspired to know more about the world around you and trust the experts who do the work, not the celebrities, talk show hosts, and politicians who have opinions on the matter. If your car breaks down or your sink is leaking, definitely don't call me. Get that expert mechanic or plumber. I'll be more than happy to help you with the science stuff. You can even join in the practice of science yourself if you disagree or have new questions to explore. You can grow your science literacy by reading about science, following scientists on social media, starting educated conversations with your friends and neighbors, and objectively getting to the truth together. And for all of you professional scientists out there, we gotta step up our game too. We gotta be less arrogant about how smart we think we are, be more accessible and engaged. We've got a lot of work to do together, but that's what the scientific enterprise is all about. Collaboration, a healthy dose of skepticism, and a team working together to collect and interpret data, ultimately helping us make a better and more enjoyable world for all of us. After all, it's science. And that's another Dr. B in 3. If you like this video, remember to like, subscribe, and comment below.